information we could use. You know.
Industry rule number 4008.
First of all, who's your A&R?
We got one more song we're going to play. What is that?
We're going to keep it R&B, man. We're going to play John Legend right now. He's coming out with a new album very soon, and this is the first single. It's called Tonight, featuring Ludacris. And you know John, he's making his rounds. He's on that Rich Forever mixtape. And check this one out, man.
888-SHAY-45. Let us know what you think. New John Legend, Tonight, featuring Luda.
And the last song, man, you know I love it. John Legend, Tonight, featuring Ludacris.
Luda!
Man, this record, it has like that real laid back groove to it. You can get your two step on. And you know, for like an early part of John's, I would say his professional career, with you know, when he signed to Sony Records, he put out a lot of ballads. He had a lot of success in songs like Ordinary People and things of that nature. But with his last album, he came out with the Green Light. You know, which, because John is not, you know, like some of the music you would think this is like a 35-year-old guy, but
right.
You know, he's a younger cat. And you know, when you hear a song that's a really good time record, like Green Light from the last album, you know, it just brought back the memories where he was singing on like all of the Kanye West,
right?
You know, College Dropout records, and even John Legend. People don't know he made mixtapes back in the day.
Yes,
so,
he did.
You know, him bringing the world of hip hop and R&B is nothing new, and I'm happy to see that he's coming back with that. You know, even the stuff that he did with the Good Music Fridays a couple of years back.
Yeah, no, this is great because, you know, I was telling you before, you know, I always tend to be a little more skeptical when it comes to John Legend, and only because, you know, not because of the early stuff he did, but at one point he had kind of, for me, had got a little too vibrato in his approach on the tracks and was a little too, you know, I'm from the church. And it's like, we know you from the church. We know you play piano. We know you're a great musician, songwriter. But I don't want to hear, you know, 20 years of church music inside of your songs, you know, not these R&B songs. And this song right here, Tonight, it's called Tonight with him and Ludacris. It is absolutely, absolutely a treat to hear. Starts off great, cool rhythm, drops into that flat four on the floor, comes back. You know, my only thing that I kind of wanted was Luda's verse to come a little bit sooner. It's a 4-minute song. Luda's verse comes around 3 minutes. I would have loved Luda's verse to come around 2:30, maybe even 2:25. But the song is still a great song. It feels good. I love to see what the citizens have to say about it.
Yeah, you know, Luda, he's one of those dudes where you could really put him on any record. He's gonna sound great. And, you know, it seems like John is—he's sort of loosening up a little bit. You
yeah,
know, you've
yeah.
seen him
yeah.
with Rick Ross and you know a couple of people. Now he's kind of okay. You want to groove a little bit, so I'm not mad at that.
Great song, great song.
3 minutes past the top. Brand new music, John Legend featuring Luda, is called Tonight. Eric Sermon, what you think of that?
That's
Eric?
Crazy.
You like that
that's
one?
That's that.
No, that's that.
Yeah, that's
okay.
That.
Okay.
Yeah.
Nathan in Pittsburgh, how you feel about that song?
I'm feeling it, man. Definitely from the critique of the last guy, that's how his voice needs to be on that last joint, man.
Okay.
Like that John Legend muscular shit, man.
A muscular. Jay in Atlanta, what do you think of that, man?
Hey, man, I respect John as an artist, man, but I ain't really feeling that shit.
Wasn't feeling it, huh?
Yikes.
Wow. Nah. Okay, cool. Jay won't be rocking that one, y'all. Paul in Pennsylvania, what you think? Did you like it or not?
Yeah, man, it's jamming. It's John Legend. You know, he's living up to his name.
Okay. A legend.
Oh,
I get
legend.
It.
All right, I like that. Okay.
That was clever. All right, and Greg in New Orleans, what you think?
Yo, man, I'm feeling it, bro. At first, I was kind of skeptical of it, but then when Luda got on it, I really liked that.
Yo, Luda's flow was ridiculous on that. Luda's flow was...
He caught a pocket.
That, yeah, he did. Ian in North Dakota, you like it or not?
Yeah, I love it. And good morning to you guys, too.
Good morning, Ian. Thanks for calling in. You're first person from North Dakota to call this week, man. Give him a round of applause. You're a citizen of Sway in the morning.
Yeah.
All right. I listen to you guys every single morning.
All right, let's go hunt some bison. All right, All right, that's the A&R room. Right, thank you, E. I appreciate Eric Sermon here. I got somebody that's rocking with me right now, damn it. Thank you, Eric Sermon. I'm here all morning. All right, so real quick, let's do our headphones, all right,
yes.
Ratings. We play Chris Cab with Wyclef and Mavado first, Rihanna's Gun, Rich Nice, real quick. How many headphones would you give it?
You know what? I love the energy of it. It felt new. You know I love outside-the-box music. I'm going to give that 4 headphones.
Shaheem Reid.
I'm gonna give it 3.5. I thought it was dope though.
Okay, out of scale 1 through 5, 5 being the highest. Eric Sermon, how many headphones?
Yeah,
did you
I'm gonna give it a shot. 3.5 headphones.
3.5. Okay, let's move on to Don Tripp. It's called Allen Iverson. Rich Nice, how many headphones did you get at?
Man, you know, I love good music, man. And the Don Tripp, I love clips. I love when a plan comes together. You know what? I think I'm gonna give that 4 headphones as well.
4 headphones. Yeah, okay, yeah, give them a 4. Shaheem Reid, what like would you that. Give it?
You know, I'm getting really worn out, and you know, I said it that I'm getting worn out of all the songs with people's names in it. You know, Ellen DeGeneres and you know, different records like that. But I thought Don Tripp came with a really dope concept, and AI is one of my favorite players of all time. So I'm gonna give it a 4 too, man. I thought it was dope.
Okay, Eric Sermon.
I'm gonna give it a 5 mics. I need
5 mics.
Wait, hold on. We gotta go to the huddle. We gotta go to the huddle.
Because it's a bigger picture than the song. He got to have that message. He gotta have that. We need Don Tripp.
You need Don Tripp. Okay, yes. Cool. All right, and then Rashad with Styles P is called The Life. Rich Nice, how many headphones would you give it?
You know, I appreciate when an artist can produce, write, and perform all in one and kind of be self-contained. I think he still has a ways to go with his project and what he's doing, but I appreciate his talent, and I think he can be the future of those kind of guys. I'm going to give him 3.5 headphones on that.
All right, Shaheem Reid, what would you give it?
Yo, I really enjoyed the joint. I'm going to give it 4.
Eric Sermon?
Yeah, I'm going to give it a 3.5 headphones, though, too. I think the beat was dope. Again, I think that the craft of the singing, too. You know, when he finds that, he's going to be crazy.
He's going to be crazy. Okay, yeah. And finally, we played the John Legend featuring Luda. It's called Tonight, brand new music. Rich Nice, what would you give it?
Man, you know what's so funny? I'm usually really... I give John Legend a hard way to go because I think sometimes he chooses the wrong tracks to jump on when he's trying to get his two-step and his wiggle together. But this delivers on all levels. The track is great. His vocals sound great. Luda. He's not giving me the extra church vibrato in his delivery. Luda came in and gave me the smashed
I'm
out
verse.
I'm going
to need those headphones, Rich Nice.
I'm sorry. Okay. I'm going to go ahead and give this 4 headphones.
Okay, damn. All right. Rob Shaheem Reid, how many headphones would you give it?
Yeah, you know, I'm all in with this record, man. I'm gonna give it a 4.5. I thought it was dope.
4.5?
Yeah. Wow.
Wow. Okay, yeah. Eric Sermon, yeah, man.
4 headphones. Dope,
thank you, E, for just answering the question. I appreciate you, man. Dev, you want to give us some info?
All I want to talk about is the Don Tripp. Yes, I think 5 for that.
Don
Everything
Tripp,
else
yeah.
I forgot okay. about already.
Okay, yeah, put him in my cloud, Don Tripp. Nice. All right, what should people look out for, Rich Nice?
Well, you know, D'Angelo is back. He just dropped the mixtape of him live performing overseas. Wow. So I think that's something to pick up just because he's a great artist.
That's
right. There's also a band called Justice, their new single called On and On. There's a Rick Rubin remix. So if you're a fan of like that Mud Club sound from back in the days, downtown, very fast forward, I think you should pick that up. It's something that's out there. The Rick Rubin mix of On and On by Justice.
Shaheen.
Yeah, well, I'm going to just give you one. Salute to all the DJs out there. DJ Absolute is coming with a record. It's called Untouchable featuring Ace Hood, Pusha T, and French Montana, man. Salute to the DJs.
Okay, real quick, Eric Sermon, before you leave, you're working with a few people right now, some new guys like Corey Guns. Who are you working with in terms of production?
Yeah, production right now, like I said, before I was on the phone with Styles P a couple days ago. He's going in hard. He got something to prove. You know, he just dropped again.
Yeah.
You know how they feel. They feel like they want hip hop. They rhymers.
Yeah.
You know, Nas too, Jada. I'm waiting for that phone call to come back because I got something really crazy that might be another record like a Y.
Oh, Y. Okay.
You know,
okay.
With the message. So I got some things really hot. I'm doing Fred the Godson. I'm trying to get, and your boy too. I want to work with him.
He wants Gillick and Gatsby.
I want to get to the point where like Shaw saying, how many beats you got at home? I said I might have about 2,000 records at the crib because again I took off 7 years or whatever. But when the young boys came to my crib. Fred said, Eric, I've been to a lot of people's houses. I've been to a lot of people's studios, but I never heard the music like this in my life.
Fred the Godson said
I was playing them and playing them. Mm-hmm. He was on Twitter.
Yeah.
You know, he worked with everybody. I mean, he's a young kid, so he's with everybody. Said. But that's how much stuff I got out there. But again, I haven't had a chance to put it out there, but now I am.
Yo, E, you're welcome to come up to the show anytime, man. I want you to be a recurring figure on this show. Okay?
Me too. All right. I need to get more of me to you so you can know that I got your back and I got money. Like, I want to put, listen, man.
You said you got some money? What do you mean?
Well, hey. I like money now.
Where you going with that, man? Turn the music down. We don't take no money here.
No, my thing is the fact that I'm trying to become the, with Def Squad Digital, the label launching as far as becoming a Def Jam, but digital.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? With new acts, the whole nine. And I have Penny backing to do whatever I feel like doing, you know, as far as TV and film, though, too. I met some dope billionaires at Napa Valley, you know, and they're my boys, you know.
All right. Well, Eric Sermon.
I got to kick it with you more.
Just abandoned me just like that.
Damn, man.
And then also the Breath of Fresh Air. Breath of Fresh Air comes out in a couple weeks.
Yes, yes. Oh. The people that up, y'all already playing the Eric Sermon, Rick Ross record too. I know y'all probably saying it, but Who Kid is rocking it. I got the on there.
You Tony got the Touch got the... Yeah,
exactly. The Way Out featuring Jimi Hendrix.
Yep.
Right. You got to play that record. I swear the message on there is crazy. You got the song called What Happened Right Now was on World Star for 2 days. Is that almost 40,000 hits already? It was crazy. So and so, because I'll be in there. You want to be a bad boy, hit Mace up, but you ain't cutting it, tattooing your face up. And you too got a chopper in the car, huh? Nah. Your star didn't make it that far, huh? That's new shit. Your sip sinking. No table. You at the bar. Mixed drinking, thinking. I used to make over 6 digits. My song was on the radio like every 6 minutes. You was like everywhere. You was on everything. Now your career went left like a rudder wing. Your career was last year. Or you ain't get the memo, motherfucker, when Craig Mack was here. That's how I feel about people showing that. Listen, man, like, if you wake up and see, you can have a career.
Yeah.
But if you follow, you won't be here that long.
There you go. Eric Sermon, legendary.
Battle tested and proven.
Yeah, yeah, I heard that. Information we could use. You know, industry rule number 4008. First of all, who's your A&R?